So the final whistle has gone at the Den, and it's the final whistle has gone for Blackburn Rovers in regards to the Championship. We are destined to play Wycombe Wanderers. That's right, next season. It is mathematically not possible. And to be honest with you, if we got, if we'd won today or get somehow managed to stumble our way into the playoffs, it would have been an absolute disgrace to football because we don't deserve it. We're absolutely shit today. We got shithoused by the shithouse Kings, Millwall. Fair play to them. They're going to be in the, well, not in the playoffs yet, but of course they keep their dream alive. Even if we'd won, it would have been a bit of a tall order because Cardiff have won as well. So they've put the calculators away and it's over. Yeah, 1-0. The only goal was an early one, a reasonably early one anyway, for Bennett. Not our Bennett, the good Bennett. That's right, got the ball in the back there. In fact, I was lucky to even catch it because our replay was, or our coverage of it. I don't know who was in control of the computer covering the replays. Yeah, it was just drove me mad today. So 1-0 loss to Millwall. They're not the prettiest team in the world, but hey, you know what? If I was a Millwall fan right now, I'll be doing backflips from that performance. They got the goal, they kept backed, they grinded to a halt, and they did the job, and that was to keep the clean sheet. Good goalkeeper they have, Białkowski. I'd love to have him, and I'd love to have any of their centre backs as well. So they've got the good foundations there, very British core, and you know what? Good luck to them. Good luck to them. If anybody was like to make us a late burst to the playoffs, it would be them, of course. Former manager of Millwall, Neil Harris, now doing a fantastic job at Cardiff as well. So the Millwall connection, get themselves up and at it into the old playoffs. But of course, yes, yeah, it's a shit one, absolute shit one. I can't really get excited about it now. It's over. Yeah, I feel very flat and lackluster and very, very bored now because that's it. We've got two games left. What's the point? What's the blaming point? What I think now is of course, I'd get rid of Walton. See you, buddy. Thank you very much. See you, Tonton Adebayo. Thank you very much. And then start planning a new season. Get the kids in, get some of the young guys in that have been sitting on the bench. And start to think about who's actually going to be pulling on the shirt next season. I know there's rumours out there that Stuart Downing's not going to be offered a new deal because of money. I don't know. I think it's an absolute stupid decision because he's been at he's in the bracket. He's in a very small bracket of player of the season. And I don't know why we wouldn't want to keep a hold of him because his vision, his experience was crucial in us believing that we could actually get into those top six spots. So that would be an absolute travesty for us. But yeah, you know what? The future is a little bit bright. The future is definitely blue and white because we do have some exciting youngsters on the cusps. And I think if we can get to like the next two games, get Brereton on there, get Gallagher on there, try and get them some goals, get them a bit of confidence as the season grinds to a halt. Today we were dull, and Millwall, you know what? They nullified us. They absolutely nullified us. But yeah, there are you know better. If we'd have got anywhere near those playoffs or even stumbled in there, we would have been embarrassed. We would have been embarrassed. We'd have embarrassed ourselves, and of course, we would have embarrassed the division because I don't think we would have been equipped enough to take him on this time out. Of course, next season's a completely new ball game. Of course, hopefully we'll have Bradley Dack with us, Armstrong as well. And then, we've got to look at the likes of these questionable characters such as Danny Graham. Is he going to be sticking around for another season? Who's going to be our number one? Of course, Walton should be going back to Brighton. And of course, the new centre-back pairing. It's going to be exciting. A little bit nervous, perhaps. I don't know. Do we already have the candidates at the club to come in? Will Andy Fisher being thrust into the goalkeeping situation? What about some of the academy prospects at centre back? Scotty Wharton's done a fantastic job at Northampton. What's going to happen with Rovers? I don't know. And hopefully, you guys, if you know, get in the old comment section down below. But today, we were Danny Dyer. Absolute disgraceful. The urgency in the first half was not there. This is the money game. This was the money game. This is where it all mattered. We had to stand up and deliver today. And we had a good record against Millwall in the past as well. And that's the thing that irks me. I was confident. I was very confident that we'd get something out of this. And today's performance was disgusting. Disgustingly horrible. And I don't know. I just don't know. I don't know where to go from here now, boys. I really don't know. Oh, you guys have let me down. Let me down. You let the shirt down. You let the boys down. You let the people at home down, because you could have delivered a little bit more than that. There was, I don't even know of any decent chances. I think our best chance was our final kick of the ball, and that was Rankin Costello of all people as well. You know, what's gone wrong with Armstrong? What's gone wrong with Graham, Gallagher, all of them? They were just starved of service. Mowbray has brought in like a bazillion midfielders, and then still they can't deliver a telling ball to the forwards. You know, I'm just deprived of passion, deprived of anything right now. I just feel so flat and like I've been smacked in the belly or in the knackers, to be honest with you. But credit to Fulham, Millwall, credit to Millwall. Fair play to you guys, and hopefully you can push on a little bit further and get into the top six at the end of the season, at the expense of likes of Cardiff and stuff like that. It's the way it is. But at least we weren't taking on Wigan Athletic today, because they put on a bit of a barnstormer. So a little bit later on I'll do a detailed review on this, and of course we'll do our match predictions for the next match day, probably tomorrow. But ultimately I feel absolutely flat as a pancake. I just don't know. I can't get excited. I don't even feel that angry deep inside. I just feel so let down. Disappointed, I think, from the performance. I think it's going to be an interesting few months, a couple weeks. I think the rumour has it mid-September is going to be the new start of the new season. It's going to be interesting to see what the next, or what the first 11 of next season will be. I'll be interested to see who will be in the centre-back partnership, who's going to be at left-back, who's going to be between the sticks. What's going to happen to the characters of today? Anyway, I'm going to get out of here. I'm going to go get the tea on. Till then, hopefully you enjoyed the video. If you did, smash that thumbs up. If you're new, smash the subscribe. We've got 15,000 subscribers this week. Smash your subscribe, smash the bell, and I'll speak to you all a little bit later on. I'm out. Thanks again for watching. Please like, share, and most importantly, hit the subscribe button to keep you bang up to date with all things Blackburn Rovers related, Championship related, football related. We've got it all covered right under one roof. And while I still have you, please be sure to check out some of the old videos scattered along here. I hope.